Hello guys, this is Indian Medico, and in this video we are going to see about miscarriage or abortion. This is a concise presentation for medical students. Miscarriage or abortion is defined as involuntary loss or termination of pregnancy prior to viability. In simpler terms, it is loss of pregnancy before viability. WHO defines miscarriage or abortion as expulsion or extraction of an embryo or fetus weighing less than or equal to 500 gram from its mother. Now let us see about the types of abortion. In threatened abortion, there is uterine bleeding without dilatation of cervix or passage of products of conception. In threatened abortion, the fetus is still viable and the uterus is the expected size for dates. Only 1/4 of threatened abortion cases lead to actual miscarriage. In inevitable abortion, there is heavy bleeding with cervical dilatation but without passage of products of conception. The fetus may still be viable, but miscarriage will definitely occur in inevitable abortion. In incomplete abortion, there will be bleeding with cervical dilatation and there will be passage of some products of conception. In incomplete abortion, not all the products of conception are passed. In complete abortion, there will be bleeding which diminishes with complete passage of products of conception. After passage of products of conception, pain and bleeding will decrease and the uterus returns to normal size and the cervix is closed. Now let us see about missed abortion. Missed abortion can lead to fetal death, bleeding or pain. In missed abortion, the fetus or embryo has been dead for some weeks but no tissue has been passed and it is not recognized until bleeding occurs. In missed abortion, the patient feels less pregnant than before. Ultrasound will reveal fetal demise in missed abortion. Now let us see about septic abortion. Septic abortion is any of the above mentioned abortions that becomes infected. Septic abortion can lead to endometritis, parametritis or peritonitis. This picture shows the various types of abortion. This is threatened abortion. There will be bleeding but the products of conception are retained and there will be no cervical dilatation. Only 1/4 of these cases will lead to actual miscarriage. In inevitable abortion, there is cervical dilatation and there is bleeding, but the products of conception are not passed. This will definitely lead to miscarriage. This picture shows the expelled products of complete miscarriage. This picture shows missed abortion. The fetus or embryo is dead for long, but there will be no passage of products of conception until bleeding starts. In incomplete abortion, only some products of conception are passed, some remain in the uterus. Now let us see about the causes of miscarriage or abortion. Major genetic abnormalities like trisomy, uterine abnormalities like fibroids and Mullerian duct abnormalities, cervical incompetence, maternal systemic disease, progesterone deficiency in the luteal phase of menstrual cycle, and immunological factors are the various causes of miscarriage or abortion. Now let us see about the pathophysiology of miscarriage or abortion. Whenever there is a positive pregnancy test and if pregnancy fails, there will be cessation of symptoms of pregnancy. The serum beta HCG levels plateau or fall. This will cause bleeding and lower abdominal cramping or back pain. And eventually there will be passage of products of conception. During passage of products of conception, there will be severe pain, bleeding and features of shock if the products remain in the cervix. Now let us see about the differential diagnosis of abortion or miscarriage. Ectopic pregnancy is an important differential diagnosis of miscarriage. In ectopic pregnancy, along with bleeding, pain and features of shock, there will be signs of hemoperitoneum which will not be seen in abortion. These signs include rebound tenderness, rigid abdomen and shoulder tip pain due to diaphragmatic irritation. Now let us see about the clinical assessment of a case of abortion or miscarriage. History should be taken. We should note the sequence of events, symptoms, menstrual history, method of contraception used, previous obstetrical, gynecological, surgical and medical history, and we should calculate the gestational age appropriately. Now let us see about the examination of a case of abortion. General examination should be done to measure the vital signs and to assess the cardiovascular status. Abdominal examination should be done to look for signs of hemoperitoneum and to rule out ectopic pregnancy. Speculum examination should be done to rule out local causes of vaginal bleeding, to look for cervical dilatation. During speculum examination, the products of conception can be removed with a sponge holder. Bimanual examination should be done if speculum examination is normal. In bimanual examination, we do assessment of uterine size, we look for cervical dilatation, and we try to elicit cervical excitation. It is pain on movement of cervix and it occurs in ectopic or pelvic infection. Artaxial mass can also be examined during bimanual examination. What are the investigations done for a case of abortion? Complete blood count and blood grouping should be done. Serum beta HCG assay should be done. Beta HCG is a very sensitive marker of pregnancy. In normal pregnancy, the level of serum beta HCG doubles within 48 hours, but this does not happen in ectopic pregnancy or in abortion. Ultrasound is another major investigation in abortion. Now let us discuss about ultrasound in early pregnancy. Transvaginal ultrasound should be done in early pregnancy. If intrauterine and viable pregnancy is detected, reassurance and booking should be done. If the viability is uncertain, we have to do rescan in 1 week. If there are no retained products, the diagnosis of pregnancy is re-evaluated and serial HCG monitoring is done to confirm pregnancy. In case of ectopic pregnancy, there will be empty uterus, fluid in pouch of Douglas and artaxial mass. In molar pregnancy, there will be snowstorm appearance. If molar pregnancy is detected, we have to do evacuation of retained products of conception and it should be sent for histology. I have done separate videos on ectopic pregnancy and molar pregnancy. Kindly check them out. Now let us see about the management of abortion or miscarriage. Conservative management involves administration of prostaglandins. It should be preceded by mifepristone and antiprogestogen. After conservative management, repeat scan should be taken to look for retained products of conception. If retained products of conception are present, uterine curettage should be done. Now let us see about uterine curettage. It involves evacuation of retained products of conception. It is also known as ERPC. It is done if incomplete or non-viable pregnancy is present. Anti-D immunoglobulin should be given if patient is Rh negative. Now let us see about the complications of miscarriage or abortion. Hemorrhage or infection can occur if there is retained tissue. Uterine perforation and bowel trauma can occur at the time of evacuation of retained products of conception. Later problems include Asherman syndrome and cervical incompetence. Asherman syndrome can occur with recurrent or overzealous curettage. If you have any suggestions, please let me know in the comment section. For more such videos, please check out my playlists. If you like my videos, kindly subscribe. Your subscription will encourage me to make more videos. Thank you.